There's no one definition of economic development. It's typically described, though, as the process of creating a strong local economy, wealth, new investment, and economic opportunity. Cities compete for investment and business attraction. Successful economic development is when all stakeholders work together. Economic development is an established practice for cities to achieve a return on investment. Business success is the foundation of economic development. What this chart shows is that there is a self-perpetuating cycle. It starts with business attraction. Business attraction results in revenue generation, which funds services and enhances the quality of life, which makes us more competitive for continued job creation and attraction. We have three major adopted documents that define the vision and goals of economic development in Tracy. General plan is a long-term roadmap for community vision and guides our growth. Strategic plan is a midterm document. Both of these were adopted in 2011. Our shorter-term goals and tasks are summarized in the six council priorities adopted in April. There are nine general plan economic development goals, but ultimately they can be grouped into three areas. These areas are job creation via attraction and retention, revenue generation, and diversification of the local economic base. As only a team of two, we participate in a wide spectrum of projects varying from policy development to specific transactions. A typical day for us includes working on a spectrum of tasks shown on this slide. Economic development is a team sport. We work with a number of local, regional, and state organizations, as well as with developers, landowners, school districts, and businesses. Partnerships are a key to our success. Cities are living organisms that undergo continued change. This slide illustrates a typical progression towards higher paying and more diverse jobs. As population base grows, workforce matures and job options expand. Balanced economies have a wide spectrum of jobs and upward mobility pathways. Types of jobs in the middle of the spectrum are the bedrock of local economies due to their middle-class nature and historic stability. Many communities protect their employment areas to preserve middle-class job opportunities. Let's look at some data on Tracy's economic development performance next. For context, this general plan land use map shows major development and future opportunities. These areas are our key economic drivers that include residential, commercial, mixed use, and recreational growth. A healthy economy depends on continued balance and synergy between land uses. We've grown substantially over the last 20 years and added over 9,000 housing units. We also experienced strong growth in home values and household incomes. Access to jobs, among other factors, drives home values and desirability of a community. While we are the largest city of the four shown on this chart, Manteca is growing at a higher pace. Population growth creates support for new retail and increases local labor force. This makes us more competitive to attract retail and higher wage employers. Workforce shortage in particular is a major issue across the nation, and population growth helps with workforce competitiveness. Tracy had strong employment growth over the last decade prior to COVID. A lot of it is due to our strategic location and success in business attraction and retention. We have been benefiting from having flexible shovel-ready sites. During COVID, our county has been the least affected out of all the Northern California counties, which is a testament to the resilience of our economy. Despite strong employment growth, Tracy residents have long commutes. While this graphic highlights our economic ties to the East Bay and the Silicon Valley, it also shows that we export workers. This means there is a misalignment between jobs and employed residents. This is a regional trend, though, and is not just unique to Tracy alone. We continuously track the composition of our economy and look to create opportunities for increasing professional and tech services, as well as finance and insurance jobs. Economic development is targeting businesses in higher wage categories to complement our economic base. We also have cannabis businesses coming in, which will further diversify local economy. Out of 3,000 businesses in Tracy, most are small business, reflective of our entrepreneurship and climate. Mom and pop shops are the backbone of our economy, yet they're more vulnerable to economic fluctuations and require support. Businesses invest in fiscally healthy communities. Property and sales taxes are our two largest revenue sources, and we've experienced strong growth in both. Property tax is largely driven by residential and commercial values and by new development value. The city receives between 0 and 17.8% of the 1% property tax based on location of growth. Sales tax is driven by sales of Tracy businesses. A lot of sales tax in Tracy is generated by non-retail businesses due to a large e-commerce presence. E-commerce activity creates a counterbalance to brick-and-mortar retail. During COVID in particular, we saw e-commerce sales increase while brick-and-mortar retail struggled. Support of existing businesses has become particularly important during COVID, and this is the next topic. ED staff is the city's data broker and provides concierge service to businesses. We're a connective tissue between public and private and develop relationships with business community to make sure they have a voice. For example, we host a bi-weekly COVID strategies meeting with small business owners. We're actively involved in various education and policy creation efforts. This slide shows the Support Tracy campaign implementation with the Chamber and Tracy City Center Association. The campaign includes a digital business database, merchant window decals, and marketing to support small businesses. Some restaurants on 10th Street reported record sales after the streetery implementation. The city facilitated various outside dining permits and waived over 3,400 in permitting fees for small businesses. We're currently working on outside dining concept 2.0. Council made strategic $500,000 investment in small business relief grant in December. The investment was particularly impactful in this community and saved existing small businesses and jobs. This program was a major success. Many other efforts behind the scenes include pursuing grants and deploying funding. This flyer is from the financial resource workshop we hosted with the Tracy Chamber and the county to connect small businesses to financial resources. A small business survey conducted in September revealed three major challenges. They are a labor shortage, increasing costs, and uncertainty from the Delta variant. We continue to work with Tracy businesses to resolve these issues, though some may be beyond local control. Next, let's talk about retail. We have commercial space across the city. Combined, there is 4.6 million square feet of retail with new development in the pipeline. Here are six common industry location criteria from retailers and brokers. These are in no particular order, and we'd like to focus on the top three because they're easier to quantify and rank. Tracy is the wealthiest city in San Joaquin County. We continue to focus on enhancing our educational opportunities. Retailers closely look at educational data in making site selection decisions. While Tracy is fast growing, our growth has been slower than other South County cities. Population growth translates into new demand for retail. We periodically conduct a community retail survey to inform retail attraction strategies. We'll issue a new survey in 2022 to remain on top of community preferences and capture potential COVID-related changes. We'll share these results with retail developers and operators to stay at the forefront of new opportunities. As shown in the summary of this survey, Trader Joe's has continuously been the number one retailer and grocery store in the city. We are in continuous contact with Trader Joe's representatives, and we're getting a consistent answer from them. Even though they're well aware of our interest in their presence, they have been communicating to us that their investment is contingent largely on improving our population density, which means that they're looking for retail locations within proximity to large population areas within short distance. They're also looking for continued improvement in educational attainment and incomes. And we continue to work behind the scenes to plant seeds and continue moving our metrics towards meeting their site selection objectives. We're very active in retail attraction space and continuously look for ways to enhance new retail offerings. We'll conduct direct outreach, work with various stakeholders, attend retail conferences, and promote retail incentives. Despite challenging times for brick and mortar retail, we have had success with new businesses. We're excited to welcome Hobby Lobby to Tracy, which is opening its doors any day now at West Valley Mall. Hobby Lobby has been long a 10 top retailer in the city, and we have worked with mall ownership behind the scenes to make this deal happen. There's a number of other new retailers locating in downtown and elsewhere in the city, a reflection of the entrepreneurship optimism about the Tracy location. High per capita sales are a testament to our strength in retail offerings and strategic positioning along the I-205 corridor. We also made big gains in hotel attraction in recent years. Prior council's strategic priorities called for more hotels, recognizing new opportunities from legacy fields, tourism, and business travel. ED staff has gone out and actively recruited various hotels to invest in Tracy. The recent opening of Home 2 Suites is an example of that on Grand Line. Hotel activity drives transient occupancy taxes, which fund services and diversify our revenue base. Next, let's talk about head of household jobs. These are defined as jobs paying $73,000 a year or above. We have land zoned for job growth. Our industrial zoning allows flexibility of building types, including flex, production, manufacturing, and logistics. These areas are where most of our head of household jobs are located. Many buildings in these business parks also include an office component. Our largest office space was located in one of the Amazon buildings. ED staff has recently toured the Zenus facility. Zenus is a Korean-based mattress manufacturer that chose Tracy as its North America headquarters. In their 600,000-plus square foot facility, they have a robust office component that houses their IT, finance, and sales staff. Business parks are a glide path to standalone office. We have 800,000 square feet of existing office space. Tracy has not historically been a large office hub, even though vacancies in our existing office are fairly low. A new office building is being developed at the International Park of Commerce, known as IPC by Prologis. IPC is a 1,700-acre master planned business park, the largest development in Prologis' global portfolio, and one of the largest in the country. The state-of-the-art business park includes a planned 30-acre employee wellness recreation area and rooftop solar to power an equivalent of half of housing in Tracy. We continuously track how large organizations make location decisions. Out of multiple factors identified in the latest site selection survey, about half are within local control. We continuously improve our processes within the development services department. As part of our competitiveness efforts, we're updating 7 infrastructure master plans, which provide more transparency to developers. We're also simplifying development impact fees and continuously focusing on streamlined entitlement, marketing, promotion of incentives, and flexibility. We also actively market Tracy to employers. This is an example of our ad from Site Selection magazine that reaches over 112,000 decision makers and site selectors. We appreciate the council's approval of incentives. These are for retail, office, industrial, and tech and innovation uses, and we actively market these for business attraction. Our permitting process is flexible and transparent. We processed nearly as many permits remotely in 2020 during COVID as we did the prior year. Reputation is important. Tracy's development process receives recognition from global brands that do business here. ED staff develops relationships with prospective tenants and site selectors, attend industry events, conduct tours, and develop specialized marketing. We focus on the attraction of high-paying jobs in renewable technology, advanced manufacturing, medical equipment and supplies, office, and information technology. We've attracted companies like Medline and Thermo Fisher Scientific and are constantly targeting companies that meet council-adopted objectives. We are located in the region with robust industrial demand, which has been particularly strong since COVID began. Industrial companies are the base of the local and regional economy. New development is increasingly technology-oriented with green features, built-in technology, and robotics. These buildings support a broader spectrum of jobs and wages. We're projected to continue our growth with regards to population and employment. Most jobs are forecasted to continue to be in industrial and business park type uses. Flexibility of our industrial zoning has strategic benefits. First, industrial jobs support a wide range of income levels, with more than 10% meeting the city's head of household target. I will say that this data is county-wide, and because the city of Tracy has higher incomes than the county, we believe that the data for the city is even higher than this. For instance, McLean pays its drivers $120,000 a year in Tracy. Jobs in our business parks provide upward mobility opportunities. For example, Amazon recently announced covering employee educational expenses. Business and industry is the largest sales tax driver for the city and is the fastest growing. This is largely driven by e-commerce. Sales tax revenue generated by business and industry funds city services like police, roads, and parks. A recent MIT study found e-commerce is more sustainable than traditional retail because of lower carbon emissions. Business parks also create economic engines that support middle-class jobs and are helping us become a regional employment hub. Even after buildings age, they can be redeveloped to meet future market needs. Examples shown on this slide are of obsolete industrial buildings being reused for new generation tech jobs. This is happening in industrial areas all over the Bay Area. The value of these economic engines is greater than jobs supported in them today. Economic development is also about informing responsiveness to change. The world has changed since 2011, when the last Economic Development Strategic Plan was completed. In many ways, the baseline data in this presentation suggests that we're turning the corner. We've identified a number of preliminary potential focus opportunities that meet our general plan policy objectives. And in the interest of time, we can come back to this slide during discussion. There are several ED items that touch on the various themes in this workshop that staff will be bringing back to council to guide ED direction in the next several months. The question for today is whether the city should be updating its economic development strategic plan, and if so, whether there are any particular areas of focus that staff should explore within this effort. And this completes my presentation.